We were discussing, before I got interrupted by the release of .NET 6 and C# 10, some of the ideas around observables in Angular. And what we're going to look at this week is a bit more about that, putting it into a slightly more practical application, and also specifically looking at a related area, the concept of the subject as well as the observable. And if you're familiar with the observable pattern, you'll know that those are the two components that make it up. So where we were last time, I had put together this fairly simple demo where we've got an observable emitting a tick, and that's happening once a second, and that's causing the rotation of the image we've got there. But then the other place I'd used it was in this possibly more realistic example of a web application, where you'll remember we had these books with ratings, and you can see the full list of the ratings there. Or if we switch to the summary page, you can see the average rating for each of the books. And we also had the ability to add another review. So if I put in another rating for Emma, make that a 4, click add, and then we can see that that new entry for Emma is appearing there. But the difference between those two was the one I had with the ticking clock, that was actually implemented using a really neat feature that we have with observables, which is the asynchronous pipe. So I could take my observable, which is called interval, and then in the template, in the HTML itself, just say pipe async, and that would read the data, handle everything for me. Whereas if we look at what's happening in the code that we had for the book reviews, all that was happening there was I had this book review repository service, and in there, when I loaded the reviews, it gave me back an observable, because that's what comes back from HTTP, but I immediately subscribed to that and took the data and popped it straight into a plain old array of book reviews, which is what then was being bound to on the templates to display things. And although that can work, it's much neater if you can use this async pipe to bind things directly onto the template. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to remove this intermediate step of needing that property of the book review and just have the observable instead. So pretty simple to do that. What I do is I'm going to just say observable, and then this is going to be an observable that's a generic for array of book review. So it's still array of book review that we've got for the data. We don't need to initialize that there anymore. We do need to get hold of the import. So that's what we've done there. And then the one last thing we need to do, this remember is just a naming convention. I'm going to put a dollar on the end of there just to indicate that this is an observable. Don't have to do that, but that's the convention that we can have. And then what I can do is in my load reviews, rather than doing that copy into there, I can get rid of the subscribe. And then I'm just going to say this dot review dollar equals all of that. You'll notice I'm still getting a slight error on that declaration. The reason being, I've declared it but not initialized it. And although I'm actually calling that load reviews in the constructor, so it should immediately get initialized, because this is in a separate function, not actually in the constructor itself, it doesn't like it. If I were to just take that out of there and put it into there, we can now see that the editor and the compiler understand that it is being initialized in the constructor. But if you call another method from the constructor, it doesn't quite work. But we can get around that. We can just use the exclamation mark that just says, don't worry about the possibility of it being undefined, even though I haven't declared that as a valid type. So that's what we've got there. And then our get reviews, again, now needs to return an observable of book review array. And we just need to put the dollar on there. And then that's our book review repository service working okay. Obviously, we've made a change to the interface of that because this type has changed, so we need to go to the places where that gets affected. And if we take a look, firstly, at our all reviews, so previously, that was getting hold of that get reviews, which is now of a different type. So if we now put observable of book review array in there, and again, get hold of the import, and then on the template in the HTML, we now need here to put that async pipe on there. Okay, so now that reviews is no longer just a plain old array of book reviews, it's an observable of array of book reviews, so we have to do the pipe async on there. So that's done it for the component that just displays all of the reviews, but we've also got our summary service. So if you take a look in there, we can see things are getting a bit complicated here, because what we did was we had this mapping, which is whereby we've basically got the logic that took all of the reviews and condensed them down into those summaries. But that reduce is a method that we had on an array. Now we've got the observable of the array. So the first thing we need to do here is change that, as everywhere else, to be observable of book review array, and get hold of the import. And then you can see the problem we've got. Previously, get reviews is just returning the array and then calling reduce on that, which is a method of array, but not of observable. So what we have to do is fiddle around a little bit. We've got to do one of these pipes, and then inside the pipe, we do a map, and then we'll call that revs, gives, and then revs. And then that is what we want to do this reduce on, because that revs is now the array. So if I grab all of that code and just pop it in there and get hold of map, which it doesn't seem to be liking, so I'll just have to do that manually. So I don't know where it is. It's under rxjs/operators. And then we'll just pop map in there. And now it's happy with all of that. So that's work for itself. I'm not going to go into the details of this logic because we went into that in an earlier video, but I will just point out one thing that can get a bit confusing, because very often I find I'm dealing with what we're dealing with here, which is an observable of array. And the confusing thing is that the array has a method called map, which we're using there. That's just called on the array. But then the observable also has this operator called map. And they're doing similar jobs. They're transforming what they process from one form into another. But bear in mind, you'll often have them combined together. One of them, though, is the one that's operating on the observable. The other one is the one that's operating on the array inside the observable. So that's our book reviews. We've changed the type. And then that gets consumed in the review summary. So again, in here, we need to change that to be taking an observable, and get hold of the import. And then finally, in the template for that, we again need to be doing our pipe async on there. So that would seem to all be working. So if I just do a save of all of those, and then if we go back to the page, well, we can see that we've got there the full list, so that part of it's working. If I go to the summary, then we've got a bit of a problem. The summary is not displaying correctly. Now, when you hit this sort of problem in Angular, it can be a bit daunting exactly what's gone wrong. The first thing I would typically do would be to bring up the DevTools window and have a look to see if there's any errors. But we've not got any errors listed there, so it's not something as obvious as that. And then what you've got to do is start putting in some debug code. So let's do that. Let's go in here and actually in the review summary, in this property with the getter for summaries, I'm going to put a couple of debug statements. I'm going to do a console.log there and just call that summaries so we know we've come in here. But then I'm also going to use the really useful tap that we have. So remember here I can do a pipe and then I can put in a tap, which simply means it won't change the contents of the observable, but it will just note what's happening. And I will just here do B for book review, and then again do a console.log of that book review. So we can see what is coming through with all of these, and just need, as ever, to get hold of the tap import. So if we save that and then go back to the screen, still not loading, but if we now bring up the DevTools, we can see the problem is it is repeatedly calling that. So we can get all of those messages coming through again and again and again. Basically, it's got itself into a tight loop where it keeps on trying to refresh and never settles down. And the reason that's happening is because when I put that together, I had this, as we said, as a property. And it means every time it tries to bind to the property, it's going back into that review summaries and reloading the observable, which is why it keeps going on and on. So all we need to do to fix this, let's just get it back to what it was. So firstly, get rid of the debug information. But then instead of making that a property with a getter, I'm just going to make it an ordinary property. So I'm just going to say that equals, and then it will only load it once on construction, basically, not again and again. And so now if we save that and go back, we can see that we've got that nice and stable. We should actually probably, just for consistency, do the same thing on here as well. So if I go to the all components, again, that has got this getter. So just to simplify matters, let's change that one as well, because it's really not necessary to have that getter in there. And so now we can see that both of those are working. So looking pretty good so far, but there's still one other feature we had here, which was adding a review. So let's add a review. Let's make this another review for persuasion and leave it at 5 and click add. And you can see it's not working like it did previously, because we should have seen at the bottom of that list there another review for persuasion. Now, the data has gone into the database, gone over to the server, because if I do a full refresh, then you can see we do get that last one in there. It's just it's not refreshing automatically within the browser application. And the reason for that is if we just take a look at the way that worked, so back in the book review repository service, when this add review gets done, it sends off the post, which is sending the data to the server. When that's complete, what it was previously doing was just repeating that load reviews. But remember, what load reviews does has now changed. Previously, it just put the new reviews with the extra one on the end into an array, but now it's creating an observable. And the problem is that this new observable that's created is not the one that either of the actual components bound to. So if we look at this, remember, we can see that on construction, that calls get reviews, which gave us the original observable, but doesn't give us the new one that's just been created when we added the new book review. So that's where the problem is. And this is a situation where we need to change this, because what we want to do is make it so that we can have our own observable that only exists once, doesn't get replaced when we add a new book review, but into which we can push any data as it comes in. So rather than having a observable that terminates, which is the one that we were getting back from here, that just gives us one chunk of data, an array of book reviews, and terminates. We want to have one that when new data comes along, it keeps on pushing it out there. And that's where the subject comes in, because the subject is kind of the other end of these things. So if we change this reviews from being a observable to being a subject, then again, get the import. Then the first thing to notice is this get reviews is still happy. So even though we've changed the type of review dollar to subject of book review array, it's still happy to return an observable. And what that should suggest to you, if you're familiar with object-oriented ideas and things like that, is that subject is actually derived from observable. So a subject is a kind of observable. And we can see that if we go to the definition with F12, there you can see that subject extends observable. And what subject basically does is gives us an easy way that we can push data into this review dollar object from one end, and it can then be extracted at the other end by the various components that we've got looking at it. So that's what we're going to do. And what that means we need to do here on the load reviews is we're going to have to put a subscribe back in here, much like we had it before. But then rather than just putting the data into an array, we're going to feed it into this subject. And the way we do that is we'll say reviews gives, then we're going to say this dot reviews dollar dot next. So that's one of the methods that we don't have on an observable, but we do have on a subject. And then if I just pass the reviews in there, that means they'll get pushed in. But what it should mean is that as well as that happening on the constructor, when this first gets loaded, whenever we do an add review and we get back the confirmation that the new one's been added, then it calls load reviews and it will push it into the subject again. Of course, you may notice a slight problem there still. When we refer to this reviews dollar, it's actually not been initialized. We've declared it as being of that type, but we haven't given it an object, which we now need to do. So what I'm actually going to do is we can get rid of the exclamation mark because we know it's going to be initialized. We say equals new and then just put empty round brackets on there for the constructor. So that's now given us an actual object rather than just declaring the type and not giving it an object. So if we now save that, and then we can see here on our book reviews, it's got all of those reviews. If I add another review, so another one for Emma, let's say, let's pretend we don't like Emma, add that, we can see that we've got that Emma down the bottom there. There is still one slight problem here though, because although that's working fine, if I go to summary, you can see that that's blank. And if I go back to all, you can see that that's blank. And so although it works if we do a full refresh, so if I click that there, that worked. If I go to summary and then do the full refresh, it works. It's not actually managing to keep going when we swap between these components. And the reason is actually that subject that we used is not quite the correct type of subject, because what happens with that is, as we start the application up, we create this subject, and then whatever page we happen to have open subscribes to the subject. The data then arrives, and because we've got one of our components subscribed to it, it displays the data. But then when we switch to another page or switch back to the original one, the data's already arrived, and so that subject doesn't have the ability to do any kind of recap or replay to tell the page about data that's already here. That subject will only notify observers about new information, not about existing information. But I use that word replay because it's exactly what we want. We have another type of subject called a replay subject, which behaves slightly differently. It does everything that a subject does, but also it replays back to any new subscribers what it is that they've missed. And we can see, again, if we just look at the definition, that is derived from subject. So it's just another subject with some further extensions. And so now, if I save that and go back here, we can see, well, we knew that was working before, but now we can switch between these views and we are getting both the tables refreshed. I can still add other reviews. So let's put another Dr. No. Add that, we get Dr. No down there. We'll have changed the rating for Dr. No over here. So all of that's working. And so that's what we need to have. So we can have just a plain old subject if components are only going to subscribe to it once and just display the data they get. Whereas if we're going to have switching between components and they need to recap or replay, then we have the replay subject. But in fact, that's probably not what you're going to use in a practical situation, because although it works here in a simple application, as these interactions get more complicated, you're going to find you're having to be quite careful as a programmer to decide when you need one kind of subject, when you need another. And also, actually, what we've got here even is a bit inefficient, because that replay subject is going to replay all the data that's come in, however many times we've added a new book review, rather than just giving us the latest data. And so what we actually use typically in more practical applications is a thing called Ngrx, which is a library based on what's possibly a more well-known library called Redux, but it's a way of managing your data throughout your Angular application so it's always up to date. And when new data comes in, it just gets distributed to anyone who's interested. So we'll be looking at that in a later video. It's all based on observables though, so we need to get the basics of observables in there first. But that was it. We looked at how we can apply this async pipe to another application, and most importantly, looked at the idea of subjects that we can use to push data in that an observer can then pull out. And we saw two kinds of subjects. There are others as well, but the subject and the replay subject we had there. So hope you enjoyed it. If you did, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.